My name is Dennis. I'm 67 years old, and I have a very large bump on the back of my head and three smaller ones on the sides and top. This is the bump on the back of my head, and as you can see, it is very loose. The bump on the top of my head's been there for 30 years. The big bump on the back is probably 6 years old, and the two smaller ones that are on the side of my head have showed up since the back bump. The one on the back of my head, I'll bet it weighs every bit of a pound. When I'm sleeping on my back, the pillow pushes on the bump on the back. I used to say that I could sleep through anything. Today, laying down really hurts. It wakes me up. I just want to get a better night's sleep. I'm gonna put my head on, adjust all my bumps so that they're covered up. I have a good relationship with baseball hats because they cover the three bumps that I have real well. The problem with that theory, though, is the bump on the back of my head is out there for everybody. When people are staring, I feel vulnerable. One time, I told a little kid that I had a second brain, and he didn't know what to think. But that doesn't happen all the time. But you know when people are across the restaurant and somebody's looking, and as much as you say it doesn't bother you, you can only take so much. And it does bother me. This is the style of helmet I used to wear. But to fit correctly, it needs to go down all the way. And with the bump in the back, it's not going any farther than this. Motorcycles have been in my life since 1971. You can experience everything. I've been on the top of a mesa in Colorado in the middle of the night, and the stars were incredible.
How's it going?
I haven't rode for a long time because the equipment doesn't fit correctly, and I should be enjoying things more than I am today. Tea, thank you, dear. My wife's name is Donna. We were married in 95, so the bump on my head has always been there, so she knew what she was getting into.
I know for over 30 years you've been telling me you're gonna do something about the bumps. I have a whole fear that one could explode. I would be lost without you. I mean, we've been together 32 years. I couldn't imagine life without you. I'm scared of the lumps because I don't know what the lumps could do to him. He's been with me over half my life. He is my life. You know. I don't know. I know you're nervous about seeing Dr. Lee because you're not really one for doctors. I've had MS since 2001. And Dennis helps me with everything I need to do. He's never not been there for me, and I want to be there for him. You don't even like it when I go to the doctor and the doctor puts a needle in me.
I've never had the bumps taken care of because I don't go to the doctor a lot. One lady, after they took the vials of blood out of me, she told me that she had never seen anybody turn so many shades of white.
I feel like if you don't go now, you're never going.
Well, sooner or later, you have to quit procrastinating. And I truly believe it's time. I'm here today at Dr. Lee's office. A little bit of anxiety.
Hi.
Hi. Hi. Dennis, right? Nice to meet you.
Yeah,
what was your name again?
Donna.
Donna, nice to meet you, Donna.
A few months ago during quarantine, I was able to meet with Dennis and Donna over video conference.
I have this other problem.
He's got a fear of doctors. I don't care if he won't tell you that, but he does. We've been together 33 years now. I think he's gone to the doctor maybe two or three times.
So I'm really glad that he's no longer procrastinating, and I'm sure his wife is too. Even from 6 feet away, these bumps look even bigger than they did on the call, so I'm really interested in looking at them up close.
The first guy said to me on the little one, the one on top, he said, when it's inconvenient, you'll get it done. And they don't tell somebody that procrastinates when it's inconvenient, you'll get it. If somebody would have told me that it's not no major, I mean, I'm not trying to dismiss an operation, but it cutting and just relieving it, you know, I thought maybe there was something.
You mean you wouldn't have procrastinated so much
probably
if you
not.
Realized how easy it was, you mean?
Probably
or are you
not.
Saying, yeah?
Probably not.
And once you're a procrastinator, you always probably.
I still have a roof repair that needs to be done.
All right, I'm going to put my mask back on now.
You want to
take a look?
Too?
Yes, please, if you don't mind, now that we're getting close to each other. Shall we take a look? Okay, first of all, let's see the baby. The baby's on top. Okay, with you. Let me take a little feel of this.
Sure.
Okay, like, I mean, I think this is probably a pilar cyst. It just got softened. There's a chance it could be a lipoma, too. And you got another twin right here.
Yeah. He thinks
actually
they're
a triplet.
You are right. There is a triplet there. Then you have this one here. My goodness. I mean, I don't know what's in there. But if this is a pilar cyst, that's the most giant pilar cyst I've ever seen. I'm feeling a little doubtful that this is a pilar cyst. I mean, the last one I saw that was even approaching this size was probably 2/3 of the size of it. I think we should do that one first, and then these three. I mean, once we get started, I'm gonna go for it. My worry is, of course, on the scalp, the area bleeds a lot. If this is attached at a wide base, it's going to be really problematic figuring out how to fix this up. I will go get ready. We'll make sure you're nice and comfortable, as always, okay? Wave yourself around, because that's your last little bobble.
Oh.
Okay? Okay, I'll see you in a little bit.
I'd totally be lying if I didn't say I didn't have a little anxiety, because it's still an operation.
Comfortable?
Yeah.
Okay, just a little baby pinch here, right, kind of where we went. Are you okay?
Yeah.
And you shouldn't feel anything. I'll have plenty of numbing if you need it. Okay, you see, you don't feel anything, right?
No.
Good. Like, I feel like you still don't trust me yet. You're like, not yet. I think it's a cyst, but I think it's a water balloon cyst.
A water balloon cyst?
It's like filled with liquid. That's why they're soft like that.
Okay.
Wow, how does a cyst not pop? Just takes a little delicate movements here for me to do this. What are you gonna do with that? How it's stuck to him like that, huh? It's a pilar cyst. They kind of break down over time, the larger that they get, and that kind of thing is just waiting to pop. It's almost like it's a ticking time bomb. So that was a big one. I didn't know what we were getting into.
Well, hopefully the other ones won't be this much trouble.
Well, I think we might need to split this up a little bit.
Oh, no.
So we'll tackle the other three in a couple days. I know that I said that I'd be able to do these all today, but because there was a lot of oozing, I'm really concerned that he could develop a hematoma there. And oftentimes when you're a little older too, sometimes you're more prone to bleeding more easily. So I really think it's a better idea for me to do this one today and have him come back another day for me to remove the rest. Hi, Donna.
I still see one left.
Yes, we did this one on its own.
Wow. I got back there and I could still see lumps. And I didn't know what to think, but one of my biggest prayers was to have the big one gone.
You wanna see what came out?
Yeah. Wow.
Oh, there it goes. Okay, do you wanna see your friend that came off?
No.
For real.
Honest to gosh.
Look, it's like gold. Look at it.
Oh, my God.
Ooh, good thing you got that out whole.
Yes, can you imagine what a mess it would have made?
All the years that I told him he had a big water balloon back there, I was right.